talking about breathing and the effects on our breathing with certain things that people are doing, especially children these days. So we've reported countless times about the dangers and long-term health impacts of vaping in teenagers, but we've never really understood the risk during this season, flu season.
And there is a significant impact. Dr. Fariba Rezaee of Cleveland Clinic's Children's joining us in studio, kind of talk about how these problems can create a real health situation for young people. First of all, this idea of vape, you know, people thought it was an alternative to smoking, that it might be okay. Mm-hmm. But you're finding that it's not only is it not okay, but it's affecting the immune system.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. So talking a little bit about the vaping and what's the vaping. The vaping devices or electronic cigarettes, basically they use a battery device that is operated by the battery. And when the battery is turned on, there is a liquid inside the electronic cigarettes that you usually put it in the pot. Mm-hmm. And the heat turns it to the aerosol that can inhale. So then when it came 2007, all this vaping, and then they were thinking that to add a little bit, they changed the nicotine inside the vape that make it a little bit smoother. They added more flavors.
Right.
And then they claim that is not as bad. So it was the fast forward in 2019, that was the numerous cases of the vaping or electronic cigarette associated lung injury were admitted everywhere in the hospital. So we also published a study of the cases of the teenagers who came to our hospital with the complications of vaping. My lab before then was studying the role of the viral infection and air pollution on airway epithelial cells, the cells that line the airways, and basically they are the first line of defense to the outside world.
So you were already studying this
part? We were studying the role of the viral infection and air pollution, but not the smoking. So I'm a pediatric pulmonologist, and when I interviewed these kids, they had no idea that as these complications. Basically, they didn't know, oh, it's just vape. Right. It doesn't affect me. The nicotine is not as bad. So they didn't know that they changed the formulation of nicotine, that you don't feel it. Mm-hmm. Or some of them were thinking that, oh, it's just the flavor. Basically, the flavor, you can eat the flavor, but you should not inhale it, let alone that flavor was coming from chemicals,
right,
which is not bad.
Right.
So basically that interviewing and seeing those kids and my publications sparked my passion that I already studied the role of the viral infection and air pollution in my lab. Why I should not study the role of the electronic cigarettes.
Yeah.
So how is it then, things like RSV, or how is this impacting, I know you mentioned the cells and how it's damaging the cells in a sense, but what is the process of this? How do we know that this is for sure taking place, and what can we do, I mean, other than quitting, to prevent this?
So what a little bit more about our study is that we basically design an equipment that we can mimic the realistic, like what happens in the real world.
Okay.
We expose the cells to the different aerosols, and then we did the viral infection.
Mm-hmm.
And we found the damage to the cells, even to the smallest dose, even of the solvent, even just the flavors, even the nicotine with the smaller amount. And then when we exposed those cells to the viral infection, we got even worse. To the answer to your question, there is no alternative. So when it's something bad, it's bad. Even the small amount is bad. And so what I always tell the kids or teenagers that I see in my practice is that there is no alternative. So, and then smoking is bad, and electronic cigarettes or vaping are even worse.
It's stuff that, you know, they don't listen to adults a lot of times too, or even doctors. But so how do you get that point across to make sure that they understand how bad it can be?
So first of all, knowledge is power. So we have to give them, you know, the study that we have shows that what happens in the cellular levels. And I'm sure these teenagers, a lot of them very smart, they read those. There are a lot of epidemiologic data coming that vaping is not good. Mm-hmm. And even if they get viral infection, they do worse than those that even they did regular smoking.
Wow.
So basically, first, knowledge. We have to, you know, just advertise it. We have to put it into TV. The teachers have to talk to them. Pediatricians, it's recommended that every time they ask about the kids, it's not just that they bought it, how about their friends? Because
right.
what we know that you can be exposed to the secondhand smoke, even with if your friends are vaping.
Okay.
So
same as regular
smoking. Yeah. Then the other thing is that these teenagers should know that there are resources available. They can talk to their parents or they start with talking to pediatricians. Also, there are some other resources that thankfully the Ohio has it, which is they can call My Life, My Quit.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's confidential, free, and customized. Okay. So basically, they can call and get help.
Okay. We thank you so much, doctor, for being here today.
Yeah.
And education is key, making sure we get the
of
word
course.
Out there. Thank you for coming
of
in
course.
Here today.
Of course. Okay. Thank you.